Get ready to match the stars. Robert Vaughn, Brett Somers, Gary Berghoff, Addie DuGaston, Richard Dawson, and Missy McCall as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 75. And now, here's the star of Match Game 75, Gene Rayburn.
What happened on Wall Street today?
Nothing. Clarence Darrow.
Oh, no, 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 my dear. I don't have his gift, his silver tongue oratory.
Yes, you do.
I thought you'd never say it.
Can I come back now?
Yes, you can. You're back. Yes.
If I could just have a second, there's something I'd like to do. Brett and I were walking along the street the other day, and she happened to stop at a jewelry store window and saw something she wished that somebody had given her for Christmas, and because I love her, I'd like to give them to her now. Brett, here are the earrings that you wanted.
Wait, these are earrings.
These are earrings that she wanted.
Of course.
She's excellent.
Can you do a sandbag?
we all chipped in, and we also bought her a card. It says, "Dear Brett, Merry Christmas. Please be sure to wear these the first time you go swimming."
Come on down.
That makes a big noise. Well, that's a belated Christmas gift. Now, here is our current champion, Sheila Stevens. Hello, Sheila.
Hi.
How are you?
I'm really fine. Excited.
You are?
Yeah.
Well, good luck to you.
Thank you.
Sheila's won $100. She's just won. That's her first game, right? And now she's going to have a go at over $5,000. And we wish her the best of luck. And I hope you'll come right back after this message. Here we are with Sheila Stevens, who's going to have a go at over $5,000. Now, ready?
Yes.
All right, Sheila, we polled a recent studio audience and we got their best response to this. Patty Blank. Now, the answer that audience gave most often is worth $500, but you've got to match it. If you match the next one, you get $250. And if you match the third one, you get $100. Which celebrities would you like some help from?
Richard.
Patty Hearst.
You want to say Patty Hearst?
I will.
Okay.
Mitzi.
Mitzi?
The little one over there, Patty Duke.
Oh, Patty Duke? Okay.
And Patty.
And Patty.
Cake.
Say Patty.
Patty Cake. All right.
Patty McCall.
Okay, so you've got Patty Cake, Patty Hearst, and Patty Duke. You want to choose one of those? Or give us one of your own?
No, I'd like to choose Patty Cake.
You want to choose Patty Cake? Was Patty Duke's
answer. I'm going to go down in flames if my own name comes up there, right?
Wouldn't that be something if we're all wrong about that? Well, we'll find out.
It would be a large ego trip,
right,
I'm sure.
Yes, indeed. All right, she says that Patty Cake is under the $500 response. We're going to find out if it's up there, and if so, where. First, may we see the $100 response. What is that?
It's a cheese, like a cheese.
Oh,
commercial product.
Here, yes.
No plugs, please. No plugs allowed on the show.
It's
Take
a hamburger.
It back.
It's a hamburger on rye bread.
Oh, that's just a hamburger with cheese on it.
On rye bread.
And don't talk back to me either. Okay, we are looking for Patty Cake. Here is the $250 response. Patty Duke.
All right. Only worth 250.
That's it.
I think I'll go over to another network.
That's not bad, Patty, considering you've retired.
For Patty Cake, here is the $500 response. Patty Cake is that. There you go. A very good judgment. Congratulations. Well done, Patty. Okay, everybody did very well on that. And now you got the $500. You're going to play for $5,000.
You're
Which
welcome.
One do you choose?
That microphone.
All right, Patty, you get ready to write, and Sheila will face me, and here is the $5,000 question. Blank morning. MORNING. Blank morning. Put it in the slide. slot. That's it. Put it in the slot now.
Anxiety attack.
Okay, now she's finished. And Sheila, we want you to give us an answer which you think will match Patty Duke's answer. Blank morning.
Sunday morning.
What's that?
Sunday morning.
You say Sunday morning. You say Sunday morning,
yeah.
Hey?
Right up there with Mickey Finn.
That's right. Okay, Patty, she says Sunday morning will match you for $5,000. May we see your response, please?
Oh.
No. No. Well, it's up to her to match you now. You say good morning.
Of course.
Well, that's all right.
Now that you see it, it really is more logical to say good morning, isn't it?
Then Sunday morning to you.
Yes.
Too.
I have okay.
She's a theology major.
Sunday did Sunday. Go through my mind.
It did, and you rejected it.
Yes.
Yeah.
I wrote Tuesday.
You wrote Tuesday.
Tuesday morning.
All right, Sheila, you've got the 600, and you're going to meet another player right now. If you're ready for that, we're proud to present Melvinny Johnson.
Melviny.
Oh, Melviny.
My friends call me Mel.
Your friends call you Mel?
Yes.
All right, I'll call you Mel, too, okay, if I may. Yeah. Is that all right?
Yes, it is.
Where are you from, Mel?
Originally Mobile, Alabama.
And you live here now?
Yes.
You married?
Yes, I'm married. I have two kids.
Okay. You ready?
Ready.
All right, I'll push a button. Ask you to make a selection.
B.
B it is. New game for Mel. Melviny. Sergeant Harris.
Oh.
The Army Bugler. Went sleepwalking through the barracks. When he woke up, he discovered he was trying to play reveille on a blank. Sergeant Harris. The Army Bugler. Went sleepwalking through the barracks, and when he woke up, he discovered he was trying to play reveille on a blank. You know what reveille is, don't you?
I got it, honey.
Mel? All right. Sergeant Harris. The Army Bugler.
Da 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 da. What a
da-da-da-da-da. Okay.
Brett, save me. This is a dumb one.
Sure, right. I'll do my best.
Here we go. Mel. Sergeant Harris, the Army Bugler, went sleepwalking through the barracks. And when he woke up, he discovered he was trying to play reveille on a...
Drum.
On a drum?
Drum.
Where do you get the drum, Mel?
I don't know.
I don't know where you got that answer.
I don't
you drew
either.
A blank and she said drum. Okay, she said drum. Robert, if you'll show and tell, please.
I will show and tell. He played reveille on a private.
Aha. Uh-huh. No match there.
No match.
All right. Now, Brad, it's up to you. Would you please give us
yes,
your answer?
Yes, I certainly
Thank
will.
You.
Be my pleasure. I understand that with women's lib and everything, that they're all together.
It's a co-educational.
And it's integrated.
Line? Yes.
And he was playing reveille on a whack.
I see. Boy, oh boy, oh boy. Gary.
Well, I happen to know he used to play with Harry James. He had a hell of a lip. Yeah. He was playing on a cannon.
On a cannon. Well, he's in the Army. He would know, you see. He's in MASH.
You're in the
and all
Army,
that,
Mr. Jones.
Patty, what do you say? When he woke up, he discovered he was trying to play reveille on a blank.
Oh, a pillow.
On a pillow.
Somebody else thought it, too.
Did you think pillow? You think that's a good answer?
That's a dopey answer.
Okay, have we come to your favorite so far? No?
No? No, it's coming up.
Oh, it's coming up? All right, let's see what you've got the popular favorite there, Richard.
What do soldiers march and fight with?
Oh.
Rifles. That's the one. All right, Mitzi, have you got the good one?
Do I have the good one? He was sleepwalking in the John, right? He wanted to play reveille. He picked up a comb.
Oh,
my Mitzi.
Leave her alone.
I'll give her some sugar. She likes that.
There's some logic to Mitzi's answer because all you need is a little tissue paper and
tissue paper, right.
And you make a great sound
great
of thing.
Great Northern and a comb
okay.
You could be.
Now, your question will be up next, your first-round question. You got zero with yours, Mel, but hang in there now. We got a little message for you, and you hurry right back. Here we are. You ready?
Yes.
Okay, this is for you. Listen carefully now. Everybody plays. It's her first-round question.
Okay.
Richard Dawson said.
Yes,
he certainly did.
Outside the studio today, I met a weird guy. He actually tried to sell me a nude picture of blank. That's what Richard said. Outside the studio today, I met a weird guy. He actually tried to sell me a nude picture of blank.
What's an easy one?
Easy? For you, it's easy. For me, it's difficult.
It's good, okay?
Yes, very good. All right? All right.
It's all right.
Great, Dad. All right. You put yours in the slot there. And yours, and we're all ready, Sheila. Richard Dawson said outside the studio today, I met a weird guy. He actually tried to sell me a nude picture of...
Can you imagine Brett?
Brett?
That is silly when we're having an affair, isn't it?
Yes, it is, of course. What did you say, Robert?
Well, Brett always wore her helmet when she played ball. So I said Gerald Ford.
Gerald Ford. Okay, Brett.
Well, I watch a lot of stuff going on around here, and I said Gene Rayburn.
Wow. All right.
I wanted to
Did
tell
you buy him?
Yes.
Gary.
What did he say?
Queen.
That was the easiest question of the week.
It is.
Of course it's Brett.
It's Brett.
I know the guy, and he is really strange. It's her ex-husband.
Did you say Brett, Patty? No? What did you say?
Lassie.
Oh.
Girl, a good girl.
And I'm proud of it.
Yes, it's a marvelous answer. Outside the studio today, I met a weird guy. He actually tried to sell me a nude picture of blank. And she said, Brett.
Yeah, we had two pictures, actually. It was a nude picture of Brett for $2. With her clothes on, it was $4.
That's what's called a natural.
Now listen. Now just don't push her too far because, yeah, Brett does have a very attractive body, and if you encourage her, you know, she'll.
If you can find it.
No, that's it. Now what do you say?
Heaven knows you've been trying.
Come on now, it's Missy McCall's turn.
Will we share a dressing room, Brett and I? Would you believe that? So trust me, the man was not so weird selling that. It was a thing of, and with
Brett,
the hole
okay,
in the
so
thing.
Okay, so there's another match for you, and you're up to three. Now, we'll push this button and ask Mel to make her selection here.
I'll try B again.
B again for you. It was so cold in the burlesque house.
How cold was it, Gene?
Thought you'd never ask. So cold that the strippers all wore blank warmers. So cold that the strippers all wore blank warmers. Am I right now, Brad?
Well, I am, sweetheart.
So this... cold the strippers.
We got one game finished within the show.
Strippers all wore blank warmers. Ready? Now we're all set, and we'll come over here to Mel. It was so cold in the burlesque house. Ask me how cold it was.
How cold it was.
No.
How cold was it?
I liked your first reading best.
The stripper, I'll tell you how cold it was. I'm glad you asked. The strippers all wore blank warmers.
Ooh. Booby warmers.
She said they all wore booby warmers to warm their boobies.
Booby.
Yes.
Booby. Well, I think that booby is a synonym for another word that means to, called boob.
Oh, yes. It's another form of the word. Right. Exactly right. Yes, Miss Brett, honey.
Oh, darling, I just seem to be setting up here doing something wrong. I don't know what it is. I said they all wore earmuff warmers. Is that wrong?
Boy, is that wrong. When you are wrong, you are so wrong, it's unbelievable.
Yes, but I dress with her in the dressing room. That is what she...
Oh, she does. Oh, I see. Okay, Gare.
She wears them in the John, too. Well, this was a not only a topless joint, it was a topless and bottomless joint. I said a boob and bun warmer.
All right, you got another one for that? So, what did you say, Pat?
Boob warmer.
Boob warmer. Now that means you're up to three, and we come to you, Richard.
A lot of people don't know I actually invented that particular...
Really? You invented the booby warmer?
Yeah, it's a plastic. It's one piece.
Yeah. Yeah.
That's called the boob tube.
There's another one. So cold in the burlesque house, all the strippers all wore blank warmers.
Well, they didn't want them to get blue. Who wants a blue booby?
Yeah. So that's five for you. Your question has yet to come up. You'll need two to tie and three to win, and we'll come right back after this. Here we go. You ready?
Yes.
All right. Now, remember, you need two to tie, three to win. Who does not play?
I don't. I do.
Well, if it says, you know, don't write, like it says in his.
Oh, but I thought it was like the don't walk sign in the street.
Oh, no.
Don't write, you scribble.
Well, you get ready. You play.
Okay, I play.
The countess said, the Marquis de Sade is mean.
How mean is he, Gene? I'm glad you asked. At my party, I caught him in the bathtub blanking my rubber duck.
That's how mean the Marquis de Sade is.
Oh!
I had it there for a minute. Is she talking or gargling?
She has a deep voice.
I'm singing, my God.
Influenced by Tallulah Bankhead.
He's icy.
All right, here we go. Sheila. The countess said, the Marquis de Sade is mean. At my party, I caught him in the bathtub, blanking my rubber duck.
Beating
my rubber duck?
He's mean.
Yeah. All right. Beating is the answer. Let's see if she scores with that. Robert, what do you say?
Oddly enough, the same marquee I know. Beating.
Beating. One for you. You need one more to tie. Brett?
No, you're in a bathtub. I went toward drowning.
Drowning. Right. Drowning is the thing. One more you need, and it's up to Patty Duke.
Well, he was drowning the rubber duck.
Drowning the rubber duck? No, that's not a match. No, fighting. Stand by for a moment. Now, Sheila, you'll be leaving here with $600 together with our best wishes. Many thanks for being with us. Sheila Stevens.
Goodbye.
Now, are you ready for this?
Yes, I am.
All right, here it is. It's all turned around just for you. We polled a recent studio audience, got their best response to this. Naked blank. Now, the answer they gave is worth $500, $250, and $100. Three celebrities are allowed to help.
Richard,
naked...
Naked.
Naked blank.
Let's naked see. Ape.
Naked ape.
Yeah.
All right.
Petty.
Patty. Baby.
Naked baby.
Baby. Yes.
Okay.
Brett.
And Brett.
Oh, I'm torn between two. I don't know whether to say lunch or lady. I think naked lady, probably.
Naked lady.
Of course.
All right, so you got naked lady, naked baby, and naked ape. You want one of those or want to give us one of your own?
I'll try lady.
You'll try the naked lady.
Yes.
That's the one we're looking for. Is it under the $100 response? I ask you, naked ape is there, no? So that's the one that Richard gave you. Looking for naked lady, here's the $250 response. Naked city. Naked lady. Who wants a naked lady? We do. Here we go. $500. Is it there? Yes, it is. Okay. Come on down here. Listen, you've got the $500. You're going to play for $5,000 now. Which one celebrity do you want to try and match?
The burden is too great. Stick with Brett.
You stick with Brett. All right, Brett, you get ready to write. And Mel, you face me. And here it is, Brett. Brett.
Yes.
Leave her alone.
Listen,
we're running a little behind time. Leave her alone, would you please? Winston blank. Winston blank. All right. Do it quickly as you can.
Oh,
right now. Mel, what answer do you want to give us which you think will match hers? Winston.
Churchill.
Winston Churchill. Okay, Brett, for $5,000, may we see your answer, please?
Do you know?
You said Winston Burdett because they're on CBS. No. Is that it?
No, the thing is, she should have given that answer to Dickie because he's English.
Yeah.
And you know, I'm such an incredible smoker. I don't know how I ever said Churchill.
We thank these celebrities, and next time you join us, we will have these celebrities for your aggravation.
Greg Morris, Brett Summers, Gary Berghoff, Joyce Buell-Font, Richard Dawson, and Connie Flack.
Gene Rayburn, Match Game 75. Join us next time. Goodbye.
This is Johnny Olson speaking for Match Game 75. A Mark Goodson, Bill Todman production. Stay tuned for Tattletales.